Welcome back to my little channel. Today's video is going to be somewhat of a rant. I seem to come back to these more often than I would like to be honest, but that's how it is. The last video I made was me pointing out the hypocrisy, the double standard, and the blatant racism of Trevor Noah. I did so based on his video on how America needs to vote, and because of this, he needed to point out how in a certain state in America, racism is driving the vote. Because 48% were people willing to vote for a female black candidate for governor, and 48, slightly more, would vote for a white dude. And after having given us several racist jokes, for example, like he will be going as 1 million illegal voters, both a reference to Halloween and the fact that people recognize that there are illegal voters in America, he then started talking about how this particular Republican governor candidate is both running and overseeing the election in his state. And because of this, there is a list of people who have been basically told you're not allowed to vote. And 70% of this list is black. The whole thing, though, is that he tries to claim this is all about racism. Not, this is all about trying to figure out where all the illegal votes are coming from. The reason why I'm making this video is because even though my previous video was, for me, rather successful, I mean, it had like 300 views, big deal for me, small channel and all that, Viacom deemed it a breach of their copyright that I dared speak ill of their political commentator. I don't know. It seems a little bit redundant. I mean, fair use is a thing and it's an American thing, but Viacom doesn't like you using their material to prove them wrong. So this is where I got a takedown notice from YouTube, or rather, not so much a takedown notice, but a notice they took it down. And I countered it. I basically claimed this is bullshit. I haven't heard anything from it since, so I decided, you know what? I'm going to make a video again. This one, obviously, aimed at the hypocrisy of Trevor Noah, but also at the hypocrisy of Viacom. Because it seems to me that you're allowed to use his material as long as you agree. But as soon as you start proving where he is wrong, Viacom will claim that you do so out of copyright infringement, and therefore you're no longer allowed to make your video. Now, obviously free speech and all that, blah, blah, blah. The real issue here is that Viacom can censor people for whatever reason they want. And I was thinking about remaking the video and slightly tweaking the parts of the stuff from Trevor Noah. And I decided, you know, no, I'm not going to do that because it's basically going to be the same video with a speeded up Trevor Noah. So you couldn't really hear it was him. And I would put a filter over the imagery so you couldn't really see it was him. But they know it's him because I'll tell you it's him. Just like I'm telling you now. Trevor Noah, for example, feels it's totally unfair that 70% on that list is black, whilst totally ignoring that the other 30% isn't. But it doesn't fit the story of racism to point that out. It doesn't suit the narrative of racism to point out that it happens more that black votes are being corrupted like this because people, well, are corruptible. And the poorer you are, the more likely you are corruptible. And unfortunately, we see that black people tend to be more corruptible in this. Does this mean all black people? No, hell no, they're talking about 53,000 voters, or at least registered votes, and out of state with about 5,800,000 voters, this is about 1%. So those 53,000 which is about 1% of the whole state of the registered votes, is contested. And okay, out of those 53,000, 70% is black, whilst out of those 5 million, almost 6 million votes, 35% is black. So most black votes are not being contested, just like most white votes are not being contested. The thing is, voter fraud is a big problem in America. Now, the one point that I do agree with Trevor Noah is that, Kemp's is both overseeing the election whilst also running in the election. Now, this is dubious. Had all his point been Kemp is both doing this and overseeing it, then I would say, you know what? I'm 100% aboard with Trevor Noah. But that's not what he's doing. He's trying to make this whole ordeal a racism thing because Kemp is running against a black African woman, and therefore, obviously, racism. Never mind that the Republican Party had black governors before they turned into the 20th century. And the Democrats didn't. Okay, fair enough. The Democrats provided the first black president. But if you look at the history of the Democratic Party, they're not that much in favor of black people. That they pretend to be now only shows their hypocrisy. Now, don't get me wrong. I don't think all Democrats are bad. I simply do not. The candidate running against, I think it's Kemp's. I have to admit, I didn't look it up now because this is a rant. The Democrat running against him might be a very honest and fair candidate. I simply do not know. That's not what this video is about. That's not what the previous video was about. What this is about, and what the previous video was about, is the vile racism to try and force people to vote Democrat. And then this video is also added the incredible dishonesty of Viacom to try and stop voices proving how racist their black spokesperson actually has become. Because yes, Trevor Noah is a racist. His main argument is, it's because of the black. Anyway, enough of this rant. Like, share, and subscribe if you feel so inclined. The original video, by the way, is still up on Kokoscope and BitChute. So if you want, you can always check it out there. Links will be provided down below. I do like to hear criticism, where you think I'm wrong, where you think I should have looked the other way, for example. By all means, feel free to tell me. And I hope to see you all next time.